All right, we're back. We're back with part two. Part two of this Orianna game. Now let's go right back into the game here. So we're back. This is about midpoint in the game. Doing all right so far. 2-2-2 is our scoreline. We've almost got our way to the Morellonomicon. We did a double Dorian's start, so we're coming a little bit of a roundabout path. Excuse me. And we're coming back. Fizz is getting a little bit out of control. That's fine. I mean, it's not great, but it's whatever. Fizz is starting to do his Fizz thing. Rotating down here to support Lucian as he completes the secure on their red buff. Great. Knock him over to deny the blast cone from their side and to help him escape a little bit quicker because these guys were rotating over. Good play there. Going up here, seeing him coming through the lane, because we are in our vision, I think it was just from the minions there. Throw this out preemptively to try and zone him a little bit. Unfortunately, we're not able to deny that ward. But then the fight's breaking out, right? So let's go back and watch this happen, right? Starting to wrap around here, but I actually kind of hover here for a little bit when this fight is coming in, right? Our whole team has positioned to set up a concave around the Baron, or the Dragon rather, and look for a pick, right? And this Yasuo, who's right here, he's in the fog of war currently, right here. Well, here, let me just confirm. He's right there, so we're a little off, but nonetheless, he's right here. And right there. He's right actually on the edge of the fog war. It's a little tricky. But this is the place where, if you look on the minimap, we've got a lot of pressure on. He's kind of right smack dab in the middle here. So we should all collapse in on him and really punish his positioning, because even though Yasuo feels really mobile, he's actually not mobile at all if there aren't neutral creeps, jungle camps around. And there isn't any in this part of the map, right? There may be back here, but once he makes it back there, he's out of this pincer anyway, and we can instead just group onto the dragon and start taking this dragon, which, mind you, if I can click. There we go. It is a mountain drake. So we do want. We do want a bad. So I'm positioned a little bit forward. It's not the worst thing to do to start the engagement here and try and force you also, especially now that, because he threw out the tornado already, we know that he doesn't have any stacks up on his Q. So if I just start this engagement right here, I've got the support already coming. We know that he has a little bit of support here too. But both of our teammates that are unaccounted for matched on their side. Well, let me rephrase this, right? There's one Mia from both sides' perspective. Right? I mean, they don't know that they're here, but they just destroyed one of their wards, so they know Lucian and Braum are here. We don't know where Nidalee is. They don't know where Zinn is. But we know that Zinn is close by. So if he's that close by, we should, especially since it's Zinn who can gap close and immediately start impacting a team fight. This is a fight we might be looking to pick. So starting this off, it's fine to have gone aggressive here. If I continue to go aggressive here, that'd be great. Because if they all retreat through here, that means we can all go straight to this Drake and just get this for free. And this ward is their only way to gate back into the pit to try and contest it. We've got the presence. We just need the presence of mind. That's a quotable. So we're going in. Because they're turning a bit like this, I start to go more defensively pathed. Might be alright to do that, because I am a squishy backline mage. And they've already got a 2v1 established here. So it's just about how quickly we can get there. Maybe it would have been better to come hot on the heels of Yasuo and have Lucian and Braum backing me up. Because that's what they wind up doing regardless. They wind up coming through this path, just like I would have been leading the charge for. Now they've already got the damage to knock out Fizz and turn this into a 3v2 until we get there. And that's very intimidating. Tryndamere flashes in to force the engagement and pops his ultimate to make sure he doesn't die during it. Beautiful. I get the ultimate and I don't quite get it onto Yasuo. I don't think this wind wall affected it. I think that was just for Lucian. So I only get the ult to Alistar. Not that great. Kind of goes back to the positioning of the ball. If we can jump back. I think I throw the ball down on a shield. Yeah, I throw the ball out on command shield. And right here, attacking as forward as possible, we'll probably place it right by Yasuo. And then once it's here, I can just ult immediately. Probably won't get the Draven, probably will get those two. Hesitate a little while, hesitate. And I actually don't use command move at all. I just wait for the ball delivery system, as it were, to bring it in. But I think too much reliance on the ball delivery system, like, it's good for an engage. Once the fight has happened, I need to just command move this right here in this direction. Place it right behind Yasuo and next, or right behind Alistar and next to Yasuo. And then instead of getting the shockwave here, I could get the shockwave here. And that means, okay, maybe Alistar could walk into more free damage and dodge it. It's about like that. Right? But Yasuo is going to for sure be hit. And it's far more important to hit this Yasuo than it is to hit the Alistar, right? So I don't want to try and hit the Tanka. Not this early in the game, at least. I want to hit the Yasuo. I'm going to hit the squishy. So, moving the ball without moving myself there, I was moving myself in the right direction, so I could then move the ball. But I dropped the second half of that. I only moved myself in the right direction, so working with my ball, not in spite of it, is something that should be doable. I tried and shield Braum. Fortunately, you can't. It didn't work out. So since so many of us are down, and Tryndamere's already back top splitting, we're just going to let him do his thing and fall back to our rules. Try and press the wave against the turret, get as much damage there as possible. Since I have red buff, want to do some significant damage here. I'm Orianna, so I already do pretty good damage because of my passive. It applies to turrets as well. Throw down the W just to respect the Fizz and get out of there quicker. Staying pretty far back now. That's good. Once they're here, I just stay way far back. Again, that's the leash range. From here to here is the leash range. So I can play really far back and make use of that during the laning phase, which I needed to do. Maybe we can title today's episode some sort of like, the ball is angry, like, the ball is mispositioned. Rotate over as soon as I get the wave cleared, to support us getting the dragon down. And then look for a chance to get Draven. I don't know if I have the ultimate available right now. If I did, I should have used it there. I think that's just a bug from so many pauses, though. So we wind up getting him down, too. Throw that out to try and get the speed up so we can keep that going. Proc the Braum passive. Great. Go back mid. Pop that. Try and work the red buff magic on the turret. Try and clear out the wave. Actions happening elsewhere. Whatever, we're focused here. Now we go in. And we actually do just barely catch Yasuo as he dashed through Zin right here. Just on the edge of the shockwave, we got him. Again, I think that was a bit risky in that we could have maybe moved it. I'm trying to do the ball delivery system too much. Oh, he was just on the edge. That's too bad. This is a great ball delivery system and everything. But, like, that's pretty much... I'm in range. That's just a command move, you know? All I gotta do is Q. Or command attack. Gosh, I've been saying command move the whole time. Sorry, guys. That's just a command attack. Right? This is lucky. But I think that would have had to be either way. Because even with command attack, I probably would have placed the ball right around there. So that's fine. Wind up getting an inner turret. Great. That's fantastic. Off of the back of starting that with a mountain dragon. Great. And I rotate up here. Before I go back, I rotate up here. Take the razor beaks. Beautiful. Beautiful. Just gotta keep doing that. We'll see if I keep doing that all game. That's what's closing. Well, the gap's actually kind of remaining. But that's what will eventually start closing the gap here. Fizz is starting to do a split push thing. So he's going to be able to keep a gap maintained between us. Just by virtue of being Fizz. Oh, too bad. Didn't quite get it there. We got to worry about ourselves right now. So there is some action here, but it's largely disengaged at this point. So I'm going mid just to reestablish the pressure here. If I can get a good chunk out of this next initial wave, it'll probably set the line, since the minions are still coming from our side as well. If I can assert myself, forcing Draven to back off, and then I can get some damage on the minions around here, that probably means the minion line will be established here, and it'll be pushing in our favor because I'll have chunked out their minions already. That will open us up to rotate for Herald or rotate for a Baron on spawn, or at least establish better vision control over this, because since we just took the dragon, we don't need all these pink hordes over here anymore. They're not doing anything for us. So we might as well establish control here. So that's what I do. We actually wind up getting a kill here, because Braum gets a really good ultimate, and Lucian dashed in and slowed him with the Bork. Great. Bring the minions in. Now we can just pressure the turret. Since Zin's pushing, we actually rotate here instead, because they've rotated to defend this turret, so we've successfully pulled them here. Great. And since this blue buff is about to spawn, we can get this blue buff on the way. Walk over. Blue buff spawns here as we get here. Take it. A nice deny from them. No blue for Fizz. No blue for Nidalee. And blue for me. Good. I'll take it. Rotate over here. Baron's busy replacing the Rift Herald right now. This is really good ball management. This is maximizing, not entirely, but it's making really good use out of the leash range. And it's creating a zone with the ball here, right? They don't want to go anywhere in this zone because one, just my W will hit them, command dissonance. But also, an ultimate at any moment can come out for me. And then, since this turret's already so low, we could turn on them, zero one of them out, drop the aggro off the one the turret turned on, and then finish off the turret before they could really effectively respond. And you'll notice they have to sort of funnel to this side. Now, Yasuo's living life on the edge, because that's what Yasuo does. He's coming here to try and place the wind wall in front of the turret to give it a little bit of extra survivability through all this. But in doing so, he's putting himself at a lot of risk of this ball. Since I'm already back here, and I can't command move or command attack this to right in between the two of them to hit both of them, it's arguable I should just ult Yasuo alone right now to start this off. Because him coming here, way too aggressive. He shouldn't be doing that. That's not respecting the potential of the ball. So let's jump back to that. I place the ball. This is far enough to where they can still disengage as soon as the ultimate starts to channel. Still far enough. Right here. Right here as he starts walking this way. Boom, I ult immediately. That should be the trigger. As soon as he starts walking in like this, and the turret's already so low, again, this turret isn't that much of a defensive shield for them anymore. I should just ult him, and look at that. This is how he backs off. After throwing it, he retreats through the ball. Now it's too late and they get away for free. That turret was dead regardless, just from the amount of minions that were there. But if I had ulted there, that was a dead Yasuo. So, I'm just not managing the ball properly. That time I had it placed well, but I didn't pull the trigger. It does no value to place the ball in the right spot if they can dance on top of it, you know? So, bit of a protracted fight. We actually get pings out on the Baron. Very early, it just spawned. We're warding up. Throw down my scrying ward here. We end up looking for a bushwhack instead. Nidalee checks, it does actually hit, so she knows we're there. Unfortunately, it probably was warded, honestly. That's what we were thinking in game. Yeah, as soon as we saw the spear come out, we were just like, it's probably warded, we shouldn't do this. If there was a chance we could have got that brand for free, we should have taken it, but no, it does no harm to rotate here and try and set up a little vision. Unfortunately, they were able to clear it right back out. It does no harm to try and rotate like that. And we got some deep vision in, you know? So this isn't bad. This isn't bad. This is very good ward placement, too. They're right at major intersections. So we basically know everywhere to get in here, right? We have vision of the lane. We don't have vision of this one path 100% of the time. But we have the main entrance to that path. We have the back entrance. We have minions that create pressure here, so we would know somebody came up through the top lane. And if there was some sort of weird TP through top, we have vision there, so they couldn't come from top. And they couldn't just ward this bush either. They would have to ward here or ward in one of these bushes, because this, we know there's no wards here. So that's good and all. Trying to position myself a little bit differently from the ball. Pick it up, just throw it forward a little bit quicker. It's fine. Shield to shove the wave a little bit. Almost get this turret. Again, good ball positioning to try and zone away. They have to respect the shockwave. Pulling it over here was to try and get damage on the minions, I think. Or to try and hit Alistair and get damage on him. It probably wasn't worth allowing Yasuo to come more confidently right back into the minion wave. But we were disengaging anyway, so it's not that big of a deal. Good. Glad I'm getting the Raptors. Again, that's going to help me come back in my CS deficit. Not really rotating to any of the farms. It's possible we should have rotated bottom there. Baron is the big objective. So there's no problem with maintaining pressure on this side. Especially because we could sweep behind this Yasuo. But this is an option. Because this is naturally pushing already in our favor, probably better to keep pressure mid and try and reestablish pressure top, which gives us control of the Baron. So Even though this is a low inner inhib, or inner inhib, inner turret, this damage and pressure is going to come naturally. This is not. So keeping this artificial pressure applied, probably good. Luckily, Nidalee can't jump over that wall. No matter how hard she tries. Lucian comes in for the pincer onto Yasuo. Yasuo tries to 1v1 him before the rest of us can come in. He thinks he has a retreat path, but we did sweep exactly as illustrated earlier. Great. He does find an ultimate, but he goes down. Nidalee's over here. She looks for a spear. Can't quite find it. Has to retreat out. So good. Trent is down here with Fizz. Again, theoretically, the lane was already taken control of. Again, theoretically, a Trend who is fed can handle a Fizz who's not nearly as fed. Not sure exactly how that works out from memory, just gauging from the health bars. It looks like it's going in Fizz's favor, but the Trend ultimate is up. So who knows? We'll see momentarily how that goes. The immediate thing is to keep pressure. Wipe out this wave. Now, this wave is already resetting at our turret. So these minions are going to be a bit slowed down, but if we kill the follow-up wave that's supposed to match this, this will get this lane to push out eventually, because once this wave crashes here, between the turret and the wave, the turret will both tank the aggro and kill the wave quicker from its turret shots. So that means this wave will be largely unharmed and be free to push pretty deep. Even though it will be delayed because it'll catch on the rest of the casters here. So we finish this out to create the pressure. Fizz actually does end up getting that. He bursts him out before the ultimate can come out. Unfortunate. Or maybe it's just the bug. Who knows? Zin goes in. He finds an opportunity to fight Draven. Good one to take. I threw down the ultimate here. Just because... like, it's already 1-for-1 because we got that free kill on Yasuo. So we might as well take another kill, because then we could theoretically fall back to Baron. Right? Certainly it would be nice to get it onto Nidalee, so we would be super safe falling back to Baron, but looks like Draven's about to ult. Take what we can get. He's an ulted Alistar. We don't want to take a bunch of fight onto him, but... he looked pretty much like he was dead, as long as we drug him back into the team fight. So I mostly use the ultimate for CC there. Turns out to be the right decision. Good use of the ball, good management. Making sure it was in position. Baron's still pretty risky. We don't have a decisive enough advantage. But we do have that lingering control over Dragon Pit still. And it's a Mountain Drake, so that'll help us with Baron in the future. Definitely one we want to take. It'll help us crack the base as well. So we rotate here. Plenty confident we can beat it, or get it. Fizz continued to split push, and we saw from this ward that he was over here. Scouting with the ball. Very good. Scouting to check for the plant, too, to make sure that I can scry and see where he's at. A little bit safer. I actually go back and pick up the ball. It's a little bit of mismanagement to have not just picked it up immediately. But it is good management to use the ball to throw and to try to see where Fizz is. Nowhere to be found. Whatever. Just pick up the blue buff, go back to base, spend some of that gold. Wind up getting the Void Staff. Thinking of going something a little bit tankier, like Rylai's. Wound up I didn't entirely need to. Now that we've cleared the dragon, and we got two mountain drakes on our side as well, the only objective up on the map, aside from their base and this outer turret, right, but we're already pressuring that with Trindamere, is Baron. Now, right now is immediately when we see that Fizz is here, right? We already kind of knew that these two were here, and notably, this is their smite champion that's here, Nidalee. But once we see Fizz is here, this is three of their champions, just straight crossing them off the list of ones that could be involved in a defense of Baron. The two remaining ones don't have smite. Sure, they're full health. Sure, we don't know where they are. But we know we've got four of us with our smite champion that can go take Baron. So that's what we should be rotating towards right now. So I start walking there. Again, once we know that this is happening, gotta go. Secure the scuttle. And we started. You started without Lucian, who went back to buy his Black Cleaver upgrade. And probably got the shard then as well. We're getting the damage. I keep the ball here. Just moving the ball back and forth between shielding, using command attack to hop sides of the Baron and keep it in range to dissonance it. And I gotta position my body here so I could command attack the ball back this way in case if there was a Yasuo like there is right here who wants to come up to try and contest. Or if they come up through this area where we don't have, where we have vision, it allows me to rotate over here a little bit more quickly, so I could still be doing damage on the Baron, but then I could exert influence over this brush and create a sort of boundary field right here. Then they would have to actively break through me to get to the Baron. Here, I have less of a defined boundary aside from the entrance to the river. So I need to be more willing to use my ball to assert that definition if it's being challenged very strongly, right? And now we have a ward here, so we do see this coming. So as this is happening, I'm doing the exact wrong thing, right? We see that he's coming up because Braum throws down the ward. We actually know he's coming already from the scry plant. Right here, I should keep my body where it's at so I can auto attack Baron, but I should move the ball here. If I move the ball, we'll make that our symbol for the ball, right? If I move the ball here, the shockwave zone prevents any entrance from this side. So nobody can come in here. This path is useless. And since we know that Fizz is here, Draven is here, Nidalee is probably somewhere in this zone because she was with them, right? And now we know that Yasuo is here trying to use this path. If we cut off this path as well, there's a Nidalee who probably can't fight, and now it's only Alistar. Alistar isn't going to take this Baron. So why not just move this ball here? You know? I can keep auto-attacking. Sure, maybe we can't burn it down as quickly as we could if I was there spamming abilities as well. But Zen's an auto-attacker. Braum's helping with his passive. Lucian's going to get here. We just need a little bit of time. Right now. Another thing, too. If I move the ball away and he keeps positioning forward like this, I can open up with an ultimate, and then we can peel away. I don't need a ball delivery system. The ball delivery system can be him delivering himself, and us deciding, because it looks like we're more and more committed to the Baron, so we force him to come forward, and then he just walks into the zone. Or he doesn't and the Baron's free. We gotta force him to make an impossible choice. But by not moving the ball, it's an easy choice for him to just walk up through no danger. And through all this, I still don't use command move to get to him. And only now do I have the potential to move the ball. And I'm still not. I positioned myself all the way back here to hit this plant because we didn't have, this pink doesn't see the back of the pit. So we weren't sure if they had vision of it. So I wanted to clear out the back of the pit to make sure. Turns out they didn't. It's fine. Now that the fight's happened, so I gotta move. Go as quickly as I can. Throw the shield to try and prevent anything. I thought he was dead, but he actually lands a three-man ultimate. That's a really nice ultimate from Yasuo. Command move, start throwing out autos. Command attack, rather. And now we're regrouped properly. We're regrouped properly. Yasuo's down. We don't know where Nidalee is. And Nidalee could be somewhere around here. In kin with Draven. Same with Fizz. We don't exactly know where they're at. But we're five men. And Tryndamere has his ultimate, so he's deceptively not vulnerable right now. And the rest of us are healthy. So this should be a free Baron. Especially because we have the two Mountain Drakes, which help us do it faster. So we need to just turn on immediately. Again, great to use the ball for now. I need to keep my eye down here and use the ball zone. Now seeing that this fight is happening, which I didn't, right? But I should have, because it's right there. I should have immediately gone down to the system because he's our smite, right? It's not like we have a Kalista to fall back on. He's our smite. And he's fighting Nidalee, who is their smite. So we want to make sure that this fight goes in our favor. This actually decides the Baron more than us starting it. Because if we all go down there and we kill Nidalee, then we can turn, and now it's even harder for them to stop us because they're not just four, they're three without a smite. Even better. Instead, Tryndamere doesn't want to ult yet, so he has to get out of the fight. Now we're three-manning it again without our jungler, who is engaged elsewhere, and we're not supporting. So we needed to be here to support him. Instead, because of that, we don't get anything. Twenty-six health. The passive dot from Baron almost got him there. That was close. Anyways. Okay, so after that happens, making the best out of bad situation, right? We've got good vision over already. Throw this down because this is about to expire so we can maintain our vision. Eat the fruit on my way up the top lane. Keep the pressure rolling up here. Fine. Because we do want to go right back on this after he respawns. I start moving over. We could have started it immediately. But Yasuo is here creating pressure, so he's vulnerable. Seeing that Tryndamere is coming, it's arguable I should have been here with Tryndamere instead of here. Because they are too far away from Baron still. And Lucian is still trying to get his red buff. So the three of us are the only ones that are free to do anything. If we can kill this Yasuo here, great. I'm a little bit further behind. Luckily, only Lance knock up on Dawn. Just come for me. But he's not going to get me. Great. Trin flashes in. But it's at this point that I realize, okay. Trin can handle himself. He's Mr. Split Push Man, and he has his ultimate. I need to go back to this Baron and make sure we do it. It was at that point. It's at this point. Should have realized it sooner. Should have come sooner. Would have melted this Baron a little quicker. There's no way I can keep up. Trin's much more mobile than I am. So unfortunately, he does go down because they beat him through his ultimate. But one guy for a Baron, definitely worth. You know, and I wasn't going to be able to make the difference there regardless. Fizz isn't even able to get the inner turret to answer. He does get away. Which, I think I chased him a little too long here. Should have been back here helping this minion wave die quicker. And applying the Baron buff to these minions. They out-rotate us here. So they get a free outer turret. Just an outer turret. But turrets are turrets. And they're still worth gold at this point in the game. Gold that's critical for them to come back. So we don't want that to happen. Then flashes in. Don't need to use the ultimate to kill there. Do use it to make sure that Alistar can't get away. Even with the later flash. Can't quite get away. With the Baron, we only have the one minion. But this is pretty low. And we got a really fast, like, he went skirmishers. Or excuse me, not skirmishers, Bloodrazers. And he built a little AD behind it. So this is going to drop pretty quick. We get the inhibitor. Don't really need to push for more. Can look for it. You can also look to rotate top, right? Create the pressure here. There's no way we're going to crack the base with four of them up. And, like, get one or two of these turrets. That's just not going to happen. One thing to look for is this bear, or this dragon that we have good control over still. Could start rotating there. Instead of rotating top, arguable we should have rotated bottom. Right? Tryndamere's already here. Sure, he doesn't have the Baron buff, but he's Tryndamere. He's a split pusher. That's what he does. He's happy to go it alone. We could have instead rotated down here with the Baron. So that's like the five man, the four people with Baron. Lucian presumably joining us. And we could have been pressuring two turrets simultaneously. Tryndamere could have played much safer because he doesn't have teleport to join us. He wouldn't have pressured as hard. But it's just an inner turret here. So they're going to more focus on this side. So Tryndamere playing a bit defensive mitigates them overcompensating with more defense. And this one, since it's already low especially, should be taken for free. Instead, we rotate top. Not the worst thing in the world because we do have waves still here. Unfortunately, they are able to pick us on the way. And that's another danger of rotating like that. That was a bit of a greedy rotation. Could have rotated this way instead. And I think I was the one who led the charge and rotated a little bit more forwardly. Maybe Zen engaged. Not going to go back because it's not me. Can't control that, so I'm not going to overemphasize it. But now we start rotating towards the dragon. All well and good. Give the Baron a little bit. Try and hold the Baron on them as long as possible. Even though we're not really trying to, like, oh, let the Baron minions do work. Take out the enemy champions. Just enable us for more free time, establishing vision control, taking down plants, setting up more pink wards, whatever we need to do, red wards. Use the ball a little bit, stay far enough back to where I can dodge tornadoes. Fine. Then we rotate over here. Too late, they can't even contest. We slam an infernal on top of what we already have. Great. No need to look for an engage, just pick up the buff. Head on out. Do you want to punish this a little bit? This is a little bit too far forward though. Down my team. So we do want to play kind of back like we're doing. Don't want to commit to this just yet. If there's a good engage here, we can make this happen, but Lucian is way too low, so there's never going to be a good engage strictly, because Lucian can't contribute. And that's exactly why. Lucian tries, and winds up just taking a single Q and dying from it. He does get out most of the coin, so he is going to enable us to kill Yasuo. I use the ball. This is a good example of ball usage, right? Place it here long enough to force Nidalee back. And then we created a divide here that couldn't be broke. And now it's Fizz and Alistar versus those two immediately. But incoming Orianna and incoming Tryndamere. It's about to be a 4v2 over here. Because I zoned that properly. So, again, I used the ultimate to try and just pull them both back. I think I was only aiming for Alistar, to be honest, or was only realistically expecting Alistar. But again, secure the kill while we can. I was expecting Nidalee to come in on me as soon as I saw her, so I was waiting for her to pounce, then exhaust and just flash the wall like I did. So I looked a lot closer than it actually was, because I very much had anticipated that. Then we rotate back mid. Rotating top, probably more effective. There is three down, so maybe letting Fizz be top is fine. Going this way is needlessly risky. We actually get the ultimate out again. I'm surprised. Maybe my cooldown, I don't know. I don't know how my ultimate's up again so quickly, but Orianna OP, I guess. This is in part because we rotated through their turret. There was no reason to do that. I put myself in a poor position. And because of that, I went down. And Tryndamere actually had to pop his ultimate too, so that means we can't keep up the pressure. If instead... So I'm so low already, right? I'm fragile. I'm fragile little Orianna, right? Using the ultimate like that places him right around me. And that means I can just immediately get popped. So I do. That's unfortunate. There's one for one so far. And we do have minions providing a little call for help here. Tryndamere didn't have his ultimate for this. Wound up still winning it. Nearly has to flash away. Don't quite get her. Wound does make it out of there alive. We're on hyper speed mode. We wind up getting that turret. And we get the inhibitor too. Two inhibitors down. Now at this point, after that fight, what I needed to be doing, since there's no objectives at take here, and there is Baron coming up in a little while, but 2 minutes is a while yet. And with the now, you can't see it because it's not that way, but there will be super minions spawning in both of these waves from here on out. So these lanes are already going to be pressuring. Let me just draw it on the mini-map here. They're already going to be pressuring into the base in these directions. So what we need to do is pressure in this direction, right? And create pressure here. And then we'll start taking these turrets for free because these pressures need to be answered. Nice little arrow frowny face there. Frown that they have to answer the pressure, right? So this is a good rotation. Just go bottom. Shove this out as quickly as I can. Hopefully, they would be able to disengage after getting that turret safely. Unfortunately, they're not able to. It's fine. We're on the opposite side of the map. Doesn't immediately affect us. Braum also starts rotating to join us. Hit the turret here. Able to tank it because it was already so low. And now we're here, right? So, we've got the super minions. Not yet in this wave, but next wave. Already starting to do work, already creating pressure. We do want to get this Baron in 50 seconds. But we don't have our jungler up just yet. A rotation over there now would get us there probably by the time he spawns. So we would still have to wait for him to get there, which is right around when the Baron itself would spawn. So we do have a little bit of free time yet. Might as well pressure the spawning turret, especially because we see Draven is here. And with two dead, this is 3v2. And able to land the shockwave on the two. Keep putting pressure on him. But unfortunately, Nidalee comes up. And now we no longer know where Draven is. So we do need to back away. We do get the turret right as that happens, though. So now that we can disengage, or now that we should disengage, the turret's down so we can disengage. That means this is a vulnerable inhib, and two other inhibs that are down. Now this inhib is actually about to respawn right now, as you can tell by the lack of super minions in this wave. But this wave's super minions are about to start doing work. We can disengage here properly, rotate mid, if we anticipated this inhibitor about to be respawning properly, which we should have, but we probably didn't. We could rotate mid even, retake the inhib, possibly get this one on as well, and if we couldn't end, then rotate, get the Baron back, finish like a textbook. See an opportunity to engage, actually get the Nidalee, makes that Baron even safer. That's the best way to start prepping a Baron, is to kill their jungler and put them at a timer past the respawn. Great. Throw the shield on Tryndamere. He's actually alright with the ultimate. I have to stay way back though, because Fizz is coming at me. Now I'm trying to auto-attack as frequently as possible, for this exact reason, to proc that Bromstone. And just barely the ball snaps back to me. The shield just barely from Command Shield keeps me alive, Command Protect. And I'm able to Command Attack him down. Try and throw out as much damage onto Yasuo as I can. But Tryndamere's died during this engagement to take down Nidalee. So I need to just run and keep myself alive. You know, Yasuo's got plenty of health. It's just unfortunate I can't help anymore. It's important that I'm alive to support whatever our next action is, whether that be Baron or whether that be pressuring this inhib. I need to keep myself alive to maintain our numbers advantage. 3v1 is impossible, right? 1v2, much more possible. These should be impossible, right? So I'm rotating away. Look at the red, thinking, no, there's no way I can do that, but I will throw down my scry on it in case if Yasuo's rotating there. Great. Again, we've got the minions already whacking away at the turret this whole time. So Yasuo's got to come answer this. That gives us free time here. Now, I'm too low to effectively come here without taking ambient Baron damage and risking dying. So what I think is, okay, I need to rotate mid and start pressuring this and help make sure that this wave can escort right in while Yasuo's busy. Should be largely a no-risk situation. Nidalee is up now. The minions actually get this hurt. But I'm able largely to walk in safely. The Baron is taken. And that means immediately these are all Baroned up minions. So this dies a lot quicker. Nidalee must still be in base or something. I don't know what's going on with her. She could have forced me away if she had come. Since she didn't, though, I'm able to get enough damage in to where I can now just dissonance to give myself the move speed and just walk away. So I don't risk dying to Alistar. Perfect. Now let's inhibitor down. No reason not to back. Only objective left is the bottom. But as you can see, we've got the wave already pushing in. Might as well buy. Grab my blue buff on rotating, on route rotating down. So that's exactly what I do. Grab the blue buff on the way. Have the elixir, so I'm extra blue as well. Come in. Lucian brings the buff to the minions in the back and clears out those last ones. The wave actually comes with us. Important. Thank you, Lucian. I almost steal that. Didn't mean to. I'm sticking with the team because Tryndamere's going in for this fight. We don't really need to fight here. We need to just escort these in. But I'm trying to, I give a little bit of shield and I have a lot of like AoE zone control and force disengage from the threat of my shockwave. So I'm trying to come here and give as much as I can. I shield up Zen. I do command attack here, which is correct. I shouldn't just wait on the ball delivery system. I need to command attack to proactively loot the ball myself. But I get knocked up. I keep throwing out the shield as much as I can. Keep trying to fight this. All the meanwhile, though, Lucian's getting free time here. That's good focus by Lucian. It would have been much better to group here, take this as well as we could, and if we couldn't, disengage and take this dragon instead, then a fight like this would have been easily won. I am able to kill Yasuo with the shockwave. Okay, kind of starts to even things up. This is what's going to make it not so even. We're able to disengage. We got a super mini wave here that we now just gave Baron buff, so this is like imminently becoming a safe position because these minions will help us. And all of a sudden, they realize, oh shit, Lucian just got them. So now Lucian's free to come in. Even if he dies taking a risky angle like this, it doesn't matter. We've got so much behind us, there's nothing they can do. Come in. Give the Baron to here. Didn't even need the Elder Drake. Take the base anytime. Pretty straightforward. Not that bad. We've had... where our play is starting to get a little bit better. We've had some rough edges in the past. We've had really clear problems. And I think in the first half of the episode today, of the lesson today, rather, we saw some of the things that I needed to change, right? I needed to be more focused on how to... I was still thinking as if I wasn't playing Orianna, right? I was thinking about my positioning, but I wasn't thinking about it in a duality of the ball's positioning, the ball that doesn't take damage as an invulnerable, and zones people very effectively, and the vulnerable body that still has reasonable damage output because my auto attacks are empowered through my passive. Those need to have different management tools, the ball and me. And that could have been done better. In teamfights and in lane. That could have been done a little bit better. I think that was the main lesson. And part of that is just, you know, not having played Orianna for a little while and whipping her out straight back into ranked. You're going to make mistakes like that. The fundamentals are going to be a little rough. So maybe whipping out somebody into ranked without having practiced them is not the best. As you can see, I've got a question from the Twitch chat. As you can see, we've been bouncing in and out of our promos for World 5. We're almost about to be back into them. So we're not quite there yet, or to get out of Gold 5 into Gold 4, rather. So we're not quite there yet, but the goal is to get there, and with review like this, focusing on these different aspects, we can enable ourselves to be a little bit better, get a little bit better management of the ball with Orianna, get a little bit better placement of Orianna's body separate from the ball, get a little bit better with that dynamic, and I think we could have won that game a little bit quicker, a little bit more solidly with a lot less risk. There was a lot of opportunity for them to come back there because we had so many fights. We had so many fights after we should have been able to just push to end. But I left room for Fizz to start getting kills off of me. I wasn't respecting Fizz's damage as well. That was another mistake I was making that game. All those things add up. It could have been a lot cleaner. Could have been a lot safer. And, you know, hopefully it will be next time. So, thanks everybody for watching. That is going to be the episode for the day. Thank you, Twitch chat. I hope you've learned a little something from this lesson. We're going to go ahead and upload this to YouTube. I'll find out the highlight. I think we probably know what the highlight was today when I got that first death to Talon in that all AD game. That was a little unfortunate, but without further ado, we're going to go ahead and wrap it up. Thanks for hanging out, and we'll see you guys next episode.